So I'm inside of Airtable Automations right now, and sometimes you run into situations where their pre-built actions of finding, updating, creating, or sending an email, those actions don't really do what you need. So you need to write a script to either transform some data, add some logic, really kind of you name it, the sky's the limit. And that's where AI comes in, is I like to use ChatGPT to actually help me write the scripts. Now, I could write the JavaScript functions myself. I've done that in the past, but there's a lot of testing and debugging and it just takes longer. So what I like to do is jump over to ChatGPT and ask it to write an Airtable script for me. And then it kind of cuts down on a lot of the time and testing and generally gives me some pretty good results. So let's show you how to do that with your Airtable automations. Okay, so I've got a base, there's only two columns, it's very simple, but I just wanna illustrate how we can use ChatGPT to write a script for us. So let's pretend in this scenario that when I name something banana, I want the color to be set as yellow. I understand I could probably figure out a way to maybe do this with like a formula, and then I could build out an if statement that has all the different things, but I am going to use ChatGPT and I want to set the single select to yellow when banana is selected. So let's just go to my automation, and my trigger is going to be when a record is updated, and I want it to be on table one and my grid view. Now, the thing is, you would probably want to name all of your tables and name your views and name your base. So you'd probably want to do that. But I'm just going to kind of monitor this fruit name field. So I'm going to choose that and let's choose banana. Okay. So now I'm going to add a script. And similar to what I've done before, if you've ever watched any of my other videos, I'm going to add an input variable. And I'm going to call this fruit name. And the value is going to come from a previous step. So it's on the left side here, which shows all the data and all my previous steps. I only have one step. So I'm going to dig into that first step and I want to pass in the fruit name. Okay. So now let's head to ChatGPT to see how we can write our script to start to do some logic inside of this Airtable script. So here I am inside of ChatGPT. I'm going to ask it to create an Airtable script for me. Now, the things that I have found that help is telling it it's an Airtable script, telling it that it should expect to receive some data from an automation. So there's different places that you can have script blocks inside of Airtable, letting it know that it's an automation. A script block and an automation can be helpful. And then lastly, telling it to set an output variable so that we can use that data elsewhere in our automation. So write an Airtable script. Let's just try this. I haven't done this yet. So write an Airtable script for an automation that receives data from the previous step. The data is called fruit name. This probably isn't the greatest like prompt, so please don't judge my prompt. The data is called fruit name. Check if the fruit name is banana. And if it is, set an output variable color to yellow. So let's check that, see what happens. Probably not the greatest prompt, but here we go. So what we know is that input config, this is good. So input config is telling Airtable, like, hey, you're going to be getting data from a previous step. So we need this. That's good. Check. The fruit name is the input data fruit name. Okay. I think that looks pretty good. We've got our color, and if fruit name equals banana, it's transforming it all down to lowercase, which is probably pretty good in case someone comes in and adds a capital B or capital all caps. So if it equals banana, then I'm going to set color to yellow, and then I'm going to output. I'm going to set my color to color. So that looks pretty good. So I'm just going to copy that code. Let's go back to my base and my automation. I'm going to paste that right in there. And now let's test it. So what I should get on the right side here is the fruit name that went in was banana, and the fruit name that came out, or the output that came out, was yellow. So that worked. So I'm going to hit finish editing. Let's just check now. Let's choose a different record, and let's choose grape. So now when I go and I run my script and I test this, I should not get yellow as a color. So fruit name that came in was grape. The color that came out was nothing. So you can see that my script actually worked. This is great. Now, you could do this to like format dates if you want dates in a certain format, if you want other sort of logic. What I like to do is come in, I start simple, and then I say, oh, well, this is working. Now I come back to ChatGPT and I say, add to the function if fruit name equals grape, then set the color to purple. So my function should look very similar to what it did before, but now it's added this else if. If fruit name equals grape, then my color equals purple. I can copy this code. I can come back here, select all, paste that in. Now let's test again. My color should now be purple. Boom. So I can keep going with that. Let's add if fruit name equals orange, fruit name, and set color to orange. So this is just me building on my script, but you could build on your script however you need. Sometimes it comes back, the script comes back, and it looks really funky, and like at reading through it, I'm like, I don't even understand what's going on. So I try it, I test it, I see what happens. Maybe it works. Or maybe what I do is I ask it to I ask it in a slightly different way, or I ask it to clean it up. And it's generally pretty good of responding and giving me a new script. So let's copy this code. We come back here, select all, paste, update. So now let's finish editing. Now what I can do, since I have a second step, and that output, if we remember that output.set, that output now becomes available to in future automation steps. So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to update a record, and the record is on my first table. The record I want to update is the one that I was listening to, the one that I was paying attention to. So that record from the first step is that ID, and the field that I want to update is color, and what I want to update it to is a dynamic variable from our second step, and it's the output color. So this should be working. Let's just rename this and call this set color, turn it on. So now if I come back here and let's change this to orange, my automation should trigger, and this should update to orange. Can take a few seconds here. And if it doesn't work, I can go back into my automation. So it looked like it didn't come through. Oh, it did come through. So there you go. If it didn't work, like let's say I feed it something that it doesn't like. So I feed it apple. Come on. I can just update it here. Apple, what's going to happen is this is going to go away because Apple wasn't in there. So it should update. It's going to clear out the color, or it might throw an error in my automation. But if it's doing something that I don't know, that green box indicates the automation triggered. but I could come back in here, I can check my run history, and I can see what was happening. So that is how I use ChatGPT to help me build out scripts that take my automations up. I use it a lot for dates, formatting dates, taking today's date and putting it into some sort of a date field, or formatting it a certain way. You can use logic to link it to other records. So there's really, the sky's the limits, but hopefully that helps. And you now are able to write some Airtable scripts using ChatGPT. So hope you like this video, like the video, subscribe to our channel, and we will see you at the next tutorial.